the Steiner HX 15x56. The HX series from Steiner is marketed primarily with the hunter in mind, and there's no denying that for long-range hunting, the 15x56 configuration is ideal. The 15x magnification ensures more image detail at longer distances, but at the same time, it is not too high. This means that you can easily use them without a tripod and still keep a steady image. The large 56mm objective lenses are also able to capture more light and thus ensure low light performance is not too adversely affected by the high power. It is for these, as well as a bunch of their other features, components, and specifications, that I feel, as well as hunting, these Steiner HX 15x56 binoculars also excel in most other general long-range scenarios. And it is why I also put them forward as one of the best overall long-range binoculars that I have tested and reviewed for 2018. I could now begin by listing all of their very high-end optical components and coating. However, one of the aspects that really stood out for me on these Steiner HX binoculars is their excellent attention to detail, which really separates the HX from the crowd. The flared eye cups, a real signature of Steiner's, is an obvious example. They do an excellent job of blocking out distractions and light from the periphery, and thus offer a far more immersive and generally better view. Then there is the click lock neck strap and objective lens cover attachment system. This is simply far superior to the usual.
Today I'm here to talk about some of the great new products from Vortex, the Viper HD 10x42. Now the first thing you're going to notice is I'm a pretty big guy and these sit in my hands just perfect. You've got this great rubber molding where your thumbs fit comfortably, and then you'll notice the eye relief comes out very efficiently and is perfect for raising up to your eyes, and you can see that these fit very well in the cups of my eyes. They're perfect for a situation where you're wanting to get that first look into country and find that first look at that animal. You use your spotting scope to pick apart an animal, and we'll get to the spotting scope next. Now, the next piece that people would probably ask me is, how about the glass? What is their quality level like? Vortex and these Vipers make a quality piece of glass that I would be confident using in the high country all over some of my favorite glassing spots, very similar to this. You can see that I've got country where there's lots of cuts, lots of little areas where you want to be picking apart. You're looking for the gray ghost. I'm looking for a high country mule deer this year, and these would be binoculars that would be great in this situation. The next piece that I want to talk about is their weight. For more great reviews like this, subscribe below.
Today I'm going to be looking at mostly the external features on these new Vanguard Endeavor ED2 8x42 binoculars. For a complete review and very in-depth look at all the features, including all the optics and the coatings and things like that, please take a moment to look through the comments, and there I have a link to my website, which contains the full and in-depth review for you to look at. These Vanguard binoculars, like the old Endeavor EDs, feature a open bridge body design. What I like about this is, it displays more of the barrels, thus giving you a little bit more surface area to hold on to, for a nice secure grip, especially if you're carrying them one-handed, through thick undergrowth or something like that. The ocular lenses on these binoculars are protected by this rain guard. What I do like is it's made out of a soft rubber or plastic, and it has a really flexible bridge. The advantage of this being that you can take them off and replace them and keep them stored no matter what your IPD setting is set at. The 42mm objective lenses on these Vanguard binoculars are protected by these soft sort of plastic or rubber lens covers. As you can see, what I like is they fit really nicely. They're easy to put on and take off, yet they're tight enough on there that they won't come away too easily by accident. Another nice thing that I like is they're tethered to the actual binocular using these loops, which means that they're always handy and easy to replace, and you don't have to go searching through your bag looking for them. But should you not want them there for any reason, they're quite easy to just quickly remove.
Hello, folks. This is a review of the Vortex Raptor 8.5x32 binoculars. I previously reviewed the Loophole Yosemite 8x30mm binoculars, and they are excellent. The Raptors are a Porro Prism design like the Yosemites, and they have a similar price. A Porro Prism binocular is characterized by the offset bodies, where the objectives are not in line with the eyepiece. Binoculars that have straight bodies with the eyepieces directly in line with the objectives use roof prisms. In theory, a Porro prism is cheaper to make than a roof prism, and therefore a binocular with Porro prisms could potentially offer better quality for the price. The Vortex Raptors are similar in price and size to the Leupold Yosemites, and I decided to. So if you have any questions, leave a comment below. As always, thank you for watching. Take care.
And I'm reviewing some impressive, yet inexpensive, Chinese glass. This is the Celestron Nature DX. Let's take a look at the body first. These are in 8x42. They have a very nice focus knob. It is forgiving, but it does stay where you set it. It has wonderful eye cups that actually are snug on the body. I don't feel like I need to have them attached right now because they're so nicely set. And of course, we have the front rain guards right there. These binoculars are very compact and lightweight, although I have to warn you, they are about 35 grams heavier than the list. I'm going to harp on truth in advertising, but I think it is more realistic to give a true weight of binoculars, especially that's something that someone can check. Someone like me, right, a reviewer, can burn a company because they're lying to you. So, you know, in this case, I think it's just a little bit sloppy. They want to make the binoculars look lighter than normal. I do need to warn you, they do have long eye relief. My guess, take care, and I'll see you next time.
Welcome to this short video overview about a pair of Carl Zeiss binoculars called Conquest HD with a 8x magnification and 42mm objective lens. These binoculars, if I'm exact, this line of binoculars was first introduced in 2012 at EVA show, and currently Zeiss promotes them as their first step in the world of premium Carl Zeiss optics. This is basically true because these binoculars are one of the most affordable binoculars made in Germany, and definitely the most affordable Carl Zeiss binoculars made in Germany. That means that they cost less than 1,000 euros, and at the same time, you get made in Germany binoculars with really more than decent, I could say, really good optical performance. The binoculars have a 10 years warranty. They're made in Wetzlar in Germany at Carl Zeiss factory, and they come together with a field bag, carrying strap for the field bag, lens covers, objective lens cover. These are objective lens covers and eyepiece lens covers, a nice neoprene carrying strap, a warranty, and a manual. So everything what you expect from a premium product. They feature Schmidt & Pechan prisms. That means that they are really short. They're really... Thank you for watching.